Hi, I'm Cressel Anderson. This is Makercise. In this episode, we'll cast some pulleys and we'll complete the lead screw drivetrain for the lathe project.
Note that these parts were cast before I completed my Internet of Things kiln project. After I made the pulley patterns, I molded them in the drag. However, the drag was upside down, so when I rolled it, those little tabs were at the bottom. That's not right. They should be on the top. So I remolded it and fixed it, and then I proceeded to ram up the cope. That's the top part. I cut the gates between the sprue and the patterns, and then I removed the patterns. I used a weird channel design here. I thought it might help with filtering out some of the dross and impurities. Once again, I used the Epsom salts, put it in an aluminum foil ball, and pushed it down into the molten metal. The magnesium sulfate is supposed to release gas that will bubble through the aluminum and liberate the hydrogen that's dissolved into the aluminum, thereby eliminating porosity in the cast part.
I release project videos early to Makercise email subscribers. If you want early access, go to makercise.com/signup.
To turn these pulleys down, I used an arbor. I drilled a hole into the pulley, and then I turned down the end of the shaft so that it would fit the pulley. Turning a few thousandths with this lathe is kind of challenging. I use a nail to gauge how much I've turned the handles, and that way I can really ease in on the diameter that I'm looking for. Eventually I got a pretty good fit, and I used super glue to fasten the pulley blank to the arbor. Initially, I was going to turn off the edges, but I decided the sawzall was a little faster. Even after getting rid of the tabs, I noticed a lot of chattering. It was because of a gap between the shaft collars and the inside of the headstock. So I adjusted the shaft collar spacing and tightened everything up. That made it a lot more rigid for turning. At another point, some chatter reemerged. I decided the bearing cap bolts needed to be tightened a little bit, and you can over-tighten them, but you can also get them dialed in where it improves the rigidity of the headstock. After I turned the front face and side of the pulley, I used a small propane torch to break down the super glue. Then I was able to flip the part around and super glue it on to finish up the other side. I turned this lathe pulley 5 months ago, If you want more real-time updates on this project, you should follow me on your social media platform of choice. The first pulley had a 3/8 inch hole in it. It goes on a shaft that I'll turn later in this video. The second pulley, however, has a 1/2 inch hole. This is so it can mount on the 1/2 inch shaft that sticks out from the left of the lead screw, just below the headstock. I used a file to knock down some of the roughness left behind. And then again, I used super glue to affix the pulley blank to the arbor. I cast a small diameter pulley that mounts on the left side of the spindle. This is the first stage of the reduction pulleys. I drilled out the center with a combination of bits, including a spiral bit, countersink bit, and a spade bit. Then I drilled and tapped a hole for the set screw. I mounted it on the spindle and turned down the outside on the lathe. I hand turned a bit of a crown onto this tiny pulley, and that is intended to help the belt track more towards the center of the pulley. I really need to do this on all of them, but just in the interest of time, I ended up leaving both of the larger diameter pulleys without a crown. I really need to go back and add it to the larger pulleys because I noticed a bit of wear on the belt, but for the time being, it's working all right. Once the pulleys were roughly finished, I needed to turn a shaft for the intermediate pulley to mount on. I flipped the spindle around long ways so I could use the other end away from my arbors as the stock from which I could turn the shaft for the intermediate pulley. After I got the first two segments turned, I had to loosen up the headstock and slide down the spindle so I could finish turning the spindle. I readjusted the tool post and then I cleaned up the inside shoulder of the spindle. I dressed up the part with sandpaper and a file, and then I used a hacksaw to cut off the part. After turning my first steel part on the gingery lathe, I cut threads using just a regular die. I threaded the other end of the shaft for a washer and nuts that would hold the intermediate pulley on the shaft. I lined up the intermediate pulley and I used a point on the end of the shaft. That made a mark so that I could drill and then tap a hole into which I would mount the shaft. I used flat vacuum cleaner belts versus the round cross-section belts described in the book. It's just what's available. I added the belts and it all seems to work just fine. The only thing is I really need to add crowns on those intermediate and lowest stage pulley. I've actually already used the automatic feed to bore the tailstock. It works pretty well. I hope this project inspires you to exercise your inner maker. If you like the video, click the like button. Check out Makercise.com and sign up for the emails so that you can get advance notice of project videos. Follow me in real time on social media. Thanks for watching.